It has been 20 years since the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame opened on Cleveland's North Coast Harbor. The exhibits and archives feature every aspect of rock and roll, roots and early influences through today's contemporary artists. No matter your taste, there's video footage, memorabilia, interactive exhibits, the library, and archives. This museum is fascinating for all ages. Todd Messick is the Vice President of Marketing and Communications for the Rock Hall. 20 years, big celebration coming up. And you marked it in mid-March. You had your, 10 millionth visitor?
We did, and it just happened serendipitously. We had our 10 millionth visitor just come through a few weeks ago, and you couldn't script it any better. This guy just got off the bus, a red-eye bus from New York City. He's a musician. He came to Cleveland to look at schools for grad school. As unsuspecting as any of us, he sees cameras lined up, hoping that he's going to get to see a celebrity coming through. And really, he's emblematic of the 10 million people that came through our doors in the last 20 years to really come to this once, this experience that is unique to any other thing in the world. This is the only place in the world that really celebrates the art form the way we do, and it tells a story of how this music has really impacted our lives. And so we really wanted to make a big deal about that. It just so happens that that happens at our 20th anniversary as the inductions are happening. It's just really been a great time for us.
You see every age group represented. You see little kids, you see preteens, teenagers, seniors. How do you appeal to all those demographics?
Yeah, it's interesting because you look at, okay, rock and roll, that's, clearly the baby boomers were a big part of that. And how does the next generation and the generation and the generation after that really embrace that? A really interesting thing about technology and media is it used to be that, that you listen to one thing. You listen to those four or five radio stations that you listen to, and now music is being introduced to kids through Spotify and YouTube and social media and video games and iTunes and all these different places. And they're so much more accessible to them that we have kids come through that are 14 years old and they have a Beatles shirt or a Who shirt or a Jimi Hendrix because they're learning. So this music, we have artists that haven't performed in a number of years that are still being embraced by the younger generation. But we also try to make connections. So when you come through our exhibits, you'll see artists like the Black Keys and Bruno Mars and Beyonce, because there's a couple points there. One is that we define it really broadly. We look at everything that came into rock and roll, which is R&B and jazz and blues and folk and country and all those things that kind of melded together to make rock and roll, but also what emanates from it, whether it's hip hop or EDM or some other, indie music that is happening today. So the second thing I want to say is that we want to try to make connections. So if you really like Jimi Hendrix, then there's a way that he connects to John Mayer. And to see how different artists have influenced each other, how there's connections there, how people carry on the tradition. So there's something for each generation, and there's also a way for those generations to connect.
Do you think, of course, that Northeast Ohio, Western Pennsylvania are the most close region to the Rock Hall, almost takes it for granted? Because the majority of your visitors are what, out of state, international?
Yeah, about 90% of the people come from out of town. We call it the Statue of Liberty syndrome. People don't go to Statue of Liberty until they're about to leave New York.
Meredith Rutledge Borger is a curator here at the Rock Hall, and we are in front of a collection that you acquired from Beyonce.
Yes, how so excited.
How does that process work?
Well, we approached Beyonce's people to see if we could get her Super Bowl outfit after her Super Bowl performance, and they said absolutely yes, and we'd like to give you a few more things as well, and we said absolutely yes, thank you.
Now, the Rock Hall, in your permanent collection, do you have a lot of different items and artifacts?
We do, but because we're a relatively young institution, the museum only opened in 1995. This will be our 20th anniversary, and we're real excited about that. But because we're relatively young, we have a sort of challenge in terms of building our collection. About 60% of our collection is on loan, and we are working really hard to get that ratio up so that we actually own items and don't have to worry about returning them.
So now you're getting ready. Your next exhibit will be the inductees from this year.
Yes.
What can we look forward to?
Well, we've already gotten some great items. We've got Joan Jett's first automobile, which is totally bad. It's a black Jaguar XKE, which is the fastest land machine that was made at the time. And she drove it off the lot when she only had a learner's permit.
Oh my God. Lucky that it's still in one piece.
Yeah, really, really. We've got a great collection of items from all of the inductees. Bill Withers, we got his main guitar that he played for most of his career and wrote many of his songs on. For Lou Reed, we've got clothing, instruments. Stevie Ray Vaughan, we have one of his signature hats and one of his main instruments, beautiful guitar. We're getting this great item from Ringo, who is finally being inducted as a solo artist. We have a drum kit that was one of his main kits from the Beatles and has never been displayed before. That's really exciting for me.
But what we do see is, and we encourage this, we see the local people come when they bring their friends in from out of town, businesses and conventions, and that's a growing market for Cleveland. Those people come from out of town, and the local people, really, it's really important for them to serve as our ambassadors. So we want to encourage them to come down. There's a discount for local people, and it's a pretty wide footprint in terms of the geography we offer. We want those people to be members and come through, not just because we want them to attend the museum, but because we want them to feel good about it, be proud of their community, and be ambassadors to bring all those other people in from out of town.
That's true, and that is, you know, what are we going to do in Cleveland? Well, what about the Rock Hall? You know, it's a big deal. We fought so hard to get it here.
I kid you not. I've traveled around the world, and in a recent trip, I was in Dubai, and I'm at the restaurant, and the waiter's just making small talk. Where are you from? Cleveland, in Dubai. The Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. Worldwide, we're known for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame and really being the birthplace of rock and roll.
Having this honor to induct Joan Jett into the legendary Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, it was overwhelming. There was so much that I could say, and she has had a life in music that is rare.
I was really gonna try not to cry and be tough, but that's a little overwhelming there. Thank you very much.
Miley Cyrus inducted Joan Jett and the Blackhearts. Joan then took the stage with Tommy James. Together they played his 1968 hit, Crimson and Clover, which she covered in 1981.
Made eternal teenagers of all who follow it. Thank you, everybody. Thank you so much.
One of my all-time favorite punk bands is Green Day.
You know, I love rock and roll music. I always have.
Fall Out Boy inducted Green Day into the museum. On stage, they played a blistering set, including their anthem, American Idiot.
I love rock and roll, and I'll love it for the rest of my life. Thank you.
Karen O and Nick Zinner from the Yeah Yeah Yeahs honored inductee Lou Reed with his song Vicious from his 1972 album Transformer.
When I watch you come, baby, I just gotta run. the traits that define a hero is courage. And Stevie had incredible courage because he fought to overcome the demons of drug and alcohol addiction. And when he did, he returned to the stage an even better guitar player for it. The only reason...
Inducting blues legend Stevie Ray Vaughan and his band Double Trouble was John Mayer. In tribute, he played Pride and Joy with Doyle Bramall II, Gary Clark Jr., and Double Trouble.
It is the honor of a lifetime to induct Stevie Ray Vaughan and Double Trouble into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
In tribute to inductees, the Paul Butterfield Blues Band, Zach Brown, Tom Morello, and harp player Jason Rickey tore it up with their version of Born in Chicago. The legendary Bill Withers was inducted by Stevie Wonder. Withers, who has rarely performed in the last 20 years, joined Wonder and John Legend for a memorable version of his song, Lean On Me.